A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 11th March, on the front page you have Lok Sabha polls from April 11 to March 19. So the Election Commission of India has announced the 17th Lok Sabha elections. Also, assembly elections would be held simultaneously in four states as well. So voting would take place in Uttar Pradesh, Bihar and West Bengal in seven phases. Also, it has been said that VVPAT machines, voter verifiable paper audit trail machines, would be used in all polling stations in the elections. So here you can see AAP. The next news is AAP asks Congress BJP to come clean on statehood. So Aam Aadmi Party, it is in power in Delhi. Delhi is the national capital territory of India. It has not been given the status of a state. So AAP is demanding statehood and is asking Congress and BJP to put forth clearly their stand on Delhi being accorded statehood. Then below you have four Indians among 157 killed in Ethiopian plane crash. So an Ethiopian Airlines flight crashed shortly after takeoff from Ethiopia, which is an African country. So it had taken off from Ethiopia's capital Addis Ababa and crashed. All 157 on board were killed. Four of them were Indians. Then here you have Kashmir dailies run blank pages. So over 13 Kashmir-based newspapers ran blank front pages protesting against the government's move to stop advertisements to two widely circulated dailies, that is Greater Kashmir and Kashmir Reader. So this is there. So the front pages of the newspapers carried only two-line captions which read, "In protest against the unexplained denial of the government advertisements to Greater Kashmir and Kashmir Reader." Then below you have the mysterious disappearance of F-103. So this is a tigress. Here you can see, apparently too old to hunt. She strayed out of Orang, the Orang National Park of Assam. So since it has been 16 months now, so this Royal Bengal tigress has strayed, and you can see trapping operation is on to catch hold on the tiger, but it has been elusive. On page 5, you have Karnataka set to tap the clouds yet again. So this is regarding Karnataka government's project Varshadhara. So this is a project of clouds, sealing. So here you can see there will be Doppler radars which would be used to keep an eye on cloud movements. So based on cloud movements, then, you know, the suitable cloud formation over areas would be identified. Areas where there is, where soil moisture is less, or where it is a low catchment rainfall area. So in these areas, then specialized planes would spray sodium chloride, potassium chloride and silver iodide. So these will condense small moisture particles into larger rain droplets and enhance the rainfall. So this is the cloud seeding program project Varshadhara of Karnataka, which has been given approval for the two actually, it was used, it was earlier also in, undertaken in 2017, and now for 2019-20 monsoon rainfalls, again such a project would be initiated, cloud seeding program. So in this earlier project, which cost around 35 crore rupees, the impact was that 27.9% enhanced rainfall was witnessed in the Lingar Namakki reservoir. So cloud seeding takes place for 90 days each monsoon. So here you can see now it is planning for 2019 and 2020, where the estimated cost is rupees 50 crore each year. Then on page 7, you have in Assam's tea estates an uphill battle against a killer brew. So this is regarding illicit liquor, country made liquor, which is poisonous, which becomes poisonous often. So here, such liquor which offers quick money, but then it results in loss of huge number of lives. So we had discussed about the Hooch tragedy in Assam. So this is regarding that. So now this article says that here there is a need for a sustainable alternative so that this trade of illicit liquor can be stopped. Then below you have when pharma companies don't pay up penalties. So there are many pharmaceutical companies which have been charged with penalties by the pharma regulatory body, that is National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority, NPPA. But then the legal capacity of NPPA is said to be weakened, That is the reason why many pharma companies don't pay up penalties and the recovery rates is quite low. So that is shown here. This is Johnson & Johnson told to pay compensation. So this is Central Drugs and Standards Control Organization, which has issued direction to Johnson & Johnson for payment of 4.5 lakh as compensation to the first patient in the faulty ASR case, the hip implant case, that is articulate surface replacement hip implant case. This faulty implant had made news worldwide, and this was actually manufactured and imported by MS Depew, which is actually part of Johnson & Johnson now. So this is the compensation has to be paid to such implant victims in India too. So that process has been initiated now. On the editorial page, the first editorial is an open field. So this is regarding the elections. The election commission has announced the 17th Lok Sabha elections schedule. And it is said that constituency level issues and national meta narratives. Meta narratives means narratives about narratives. The term meta means narratives talks. So talks about talks. So constituency level issues and talks about the talks which are going on related to various aspects. So that hold the key to elections in Uttar Pradesh. So that is discussed here. And this is resolution at last. So this is regarding SR Steel case, which had gone to National Company Law Tribunal, and we have finally got the order from NCLT. So it has approved Arcelor Mittal's bid in the insolvent SR Steel. So this was in news. We had discussed earlier how the promoters of SR Steel themselves, the Ruya brothers, later made an offer, but then when they had declared themselves unable to pay, then in the resolution, how can they come up with a better deal? So that was rejected. So this SR Steel case, it says, has clarified many aspects of the insolvency and bankruptcy court process. It has finally been resolved. Then the lead article is bringing politics back in. So it has been seen that politics is being taken out of the public sphere. Means people cannot discuss about politics, people cannot question the government, people cannot ask difficult questions. So this is the atmosphere which we see presently. So the issue of national security is put forth, and it is said don't ask questions. Like if the attacks, the airstrikes, if you have doubts about it, don't ask questions. On the Rafael deal, it is for on ground of national security, you should not ask questions. So this atmosphere of do not politicize, do not ask difficult questions, this has to change is what this article is talking about. And below you have the flawed unit of academic quotas. So it says that much more needs to be done to improve faculty diversity on university campuses. So in quotas in academic teaching as such is discussed. And then on the op-ed page, there is no important news. On page 10, you have Sukhoi is hobbled by lack of blast pens near LOC. So this is regarding the Sukhoi 30. So there are no strike-proof shelters for them. They have been brought 2 decades back. But then another 4 years, it is said, will be required to build the strike-proof shelters. So they were not being used to intercept Pakistan Air Force jets because of this lack of strike-proof shelters. Then this is US moves to get China's support for listing Azhar. So this is regarding Maulana Masood Azhar. When attempts have been made to again, with international support now, to name him as a terrorist under the UN Security Council 1267 committee, so that global sanctions can be imposed on him. So the US is now asking for China support. Then below you have offset contracts in Rafael deal need to be studied. So this is regarding the offset contracts which are there, which have roped in Reliance, which is a newcomer, Anil Ambani's Reliance Group, which is not having any experience in defense sector. So that has been chosen as the offset partner. Earlier, it was Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, the defense public sector undertaking, which was part of the deal, which was scrapped, and the new government-to-government agreement was signed for just 36 Rafael jets, with Reliance as an offset partner. Means 50% of the payment which India would do would come back to India and would come back to Anil Ambani. That is so, this is It is said usually a supplier invests 30% of the contract value in the buyer country, but in this case, Dassault agreed to invest 50%. And this is relevance of proof matters, not means. So this is regarding the Rafael case again. This is the papers regarding the internal papers, the file notings have come out about the entire process through which Rafael was procured. So on this, the government said that these documents are stolen documents and they should not be admissible in court. But then the Supreme Court said that they would look at the evidence, not if they are stolen or not. So there is a precedent to this too. The 1973 order, Supreme Court had said that it is not concerned about how evidence is obtained. So if it is stolen evidence, it does not mean that it will not be admissible. So this is the Puranmal case judgment of the Supreme Court in 1973, which is discussed here on this issue. Then on the international case, this is the coverage on the Ethiopian airline tragedy, the aircraft which crashed with all on board dying. Then on business page you have India asks Saudi to invest in strategic oil storage. So this is regarding India inviting Saudi Arabia to invest in its strategic petroleum reserve program, the Indian strategic petroleum reserve program. So India has built a 5.53 million tons of oil. You can see oil reserve here. So India is asking Saudi Arabia to invest in our project. So this is here. India has built 5.33 million tons of emergency storage. It's called India's Strategic Petroleum Reserve Program. So this is underground rock caverns which have oil stored. So we have enough oil to meet 9.5 days requirement. So there are these are located in three locations presently: Mangalore, and Padur, which are in Karnataka, and Vishakhapatnam in Andhra Pradesh. Also, Saudi Arabia is involved in this refinery project also. So this is a $44 billion refinery project, which is said to be the world, which is in Maharashtra. So Maharashtra government denied land at the initial site. So now it is proposed, this project is proposed to be revived. So it is a deal, you can see. So regarding, you know, 60 million ton a year mega oil refinery cum petrochemical complex. So this talks on this is also going on. Said to be the largest greenfield refinery in the world. It will cost $44 billion. It was a joint venture, West Coast Refinery and Petrochemical Project of Maharashtra. Then on Mondays, you have this business review coverage. So here, this is regarding a swift response could have saved banks. So this is regarding SWIFT. You should know in detail about this, the SWIFT infrastructure, which is Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunications, a global messaging software that enables financial entities to send and receive information about financial transactions in a secure, standardized and reliable environment. So it's only sending messages, it's not undertaking any financial transactions. So the SWIFT infrastructure has to be integrated with the core banking solutions, and this has been mandated for banks in India. Some banks which were not implementing this have been fined by RBI presently. So that was in news. So this is that issue discussed here. And this is regarding H-1B visa of USA. So its details are given here regarding, you know, the approval ratings, its scrutiny as such. So the details are provided here. And this is wind loses energy as policy paralysis blows through this renewable sector. So how wind energy sector has been suffering because of policy not being favorable to it. So this is it is said that from 5,500 megawatts in 2016-17, capacity addition has fallen significantly in the subsequent 2 years, leaving 4,000 small and medium enterprises that supply components to turbine makers being severely affected. And there is no news on the last page. So these are the important headlines from today's newspaper. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com, download the detailed PDF too, and enroll for our video course, detailed video course for current affairs on a daily basis. So that is it. Thank you.